Management and the speaker is Sri K. Damodar Prasad, retired senior financial advisor, presently faculty at Girifarm Secunderabad. A brief introduction of Sri K. Damodar Prasad. Sri Damodar Prasad joined the Railway Accounts Department in the year 1979 and entered the supervisory cadre in the year 1986. He has a distinction of clearing all the three groups of the Appendix PA examination and has wide working experience in general accounts, workshop accounts, construction accounts and divisional accounts. Mr. Damodar Prasad entered the gazetted cadre in the year 2000 and worked in South Central Railway Headquarters Office in Pensions and PF Section, Finance Establishment, Expenditure, Draft Paras, General Inspection and Budget. He has a passion for teaching railway accounts for 2A and 3A aspirants. And he has been a visiting faculty at Sitara and ZRPI. Since his retirement in 2014, he is presently associated as faculty at IRIFM Secunderabad. We are indeed fortunate to have him share his experience in finance establishment matters, having served as a guested officer in that section. Welcome, Sir Damodar Prasad, sir. And over to you for further lecture.
Thank you very much. Thank you for your kind words.
Thank you, sir.
I am very happy to address you in this very interesting subject of finance establishment and very important subject also. Finance expenditure, if any mistake is done, it will end with that particular proposal only. But in finance establishment, the repercussions will last long. Years together, the repercussions will be there and railway has to bear it. Finance establishment per se, it gained importance because the staff cost going up from year to year. Moreover, the staff cost control, it is not in our hands. Suppose successive pay commissions come, and the cost of staff will increase, and some new assets we will be creating, and when we create new assets, manning those assets, we require manpower. So in such a situation, the requirement of staff without reviewing the existing pattern, if we continue to give as per the yardsticks or as per the norms or as per the benchmarking, the on establishment side will go up and it will become unwieldy. We all knew, especially in this pandemic situation, all of us, we knew that even though no trains are running, the staff payments have to be made. I'm not suggesting that they should be stopped. What I want to say is, all these are fixed costs. When it is fixed cost, when you run the train or don't run the train, when there are no operations or operations, when you do, then you need to pay these amounts, and it will be one side earnings are not there, and second side the expenditure you have to incur. So in such a situation, our finance establishment will play a vital role. With that background, now let us go into the topic. This finance establishment,
सर स्टेबिलिटी फंड कब देता है, मतलब जो है प्रोसेसिंग चार्ज आप बोल सकते हैं तो हमेशा फर्स्ट लोन में कटेगा, उसके बाद फिर 10,000 कर लेते हैं कितना काटेंगे, 100 रुपये, 4,00,000 कर लेंगे तो 4,000 काट लेंगे, 4,500 रुपये का लोन, 10,000 का लोन दीजिए।
सो ऑन staff side, only few elements only we can cut. The remaining thing, it is not controllable. We all knew DA, OT and DA came, these are, we, normally we call them as controllable PUs, controllable PUs, especially on staff side. All of the remaining, it is not in our hands and so it is not controlled. So, and whatever we say that it, these are controllable things, the amount involved will be very, very marginal. So, where the large chunk of the expenditure will be, it is in our basic pay and DA. And basic pay and DA, they are not in our hands. So, it is necessary that whenever we give concurrence for the posts, we need to keep that in view, that we can do little once the post is sanctioned. Keep this particular aspect in our mind. Then another thing is staff costs, they are increasing from year to year. Predominantly, especially whenever our pay commission is announced, then there will be huge jump in our pay and advances. Or whenever any recruitments are there, then there will be huge jump in our staff costs. That also we have to. Then when we are making up technological operations and improvements, we are using the machinery, machines. So when we are using the machines, some of our human effort we are relegating to the machines. So to that extent, there is a need for reduction in our staff cost and staff strength also. I'll show some of the figures where even though we were striving to reduce our staff strength, we are to reduce to the extent that is required. Because our organization structure is like that, then all of you will agree with me. Of late, the outsourcing has become a order of the day within the sanction strength. But if vacancies are there, they ask these many vacancies are there. And these are the mandatory works that are required to be done. So therefore, I want to go for outsourcing. Once you give concurrence, normally we will be keeping a tag that whenever vacancies are filled up, you have to discontinue this particular arrangement. Any machinery that, yes, there is a recruitment, therefore this activity to be stopped and contract has been ended. In my experience, I can say that kind of the link between finance expenditure and finance establishment, they are not there. Only they come for how many vacancies are there, that save statement, sanction, actuals, vacancies and excesses. So that save statement, once it is vetted, directs the matter. So this, the number is not decreasing. So what is happening? So the fixed cost, it is already there, and in addition to that, outsourcing, because of outsourcing, though not on staff cost, but there is an increase in the expenses. So that also we have to keep in mind. So this finance establishment, whenever whoever are working, so you will appreciate that the at creation stage only that the expenditure can be controlled. In budget, at top level, when at budget stage only the expenditure can be controlled. If there is no budget, then expenditure control will not be there. Similar way, so we have to put a peg. So that peg is finance establishment section. It has to do at that stage of creation. But later on, due to technological improvements, some work was reduced or some work was completely eliminated, totally eliminated. So how do we know as a in a finance expenditure, do we get any such proposals? Absolutely no. Only at creation stage only they come. So therefore, the responsibility of pockets of redundancy in the activities, some activities were not there, some activities were given to technology. So therefore, there is a reduction of work. So therefore, those staff whoever are there, they can be effectively redeployed without going in for creation of posts or the new assets that may come up. So such thing can be done only by executive. By surrendering posts, they can do that. By that is identifying surplus posts and surrendering them and keeping them in the vacancy bank, that can be done only by executive. But you will be surprised, sir, why at all they will be doing such a thing? I will let you know. There is a reason that they have to continuously look, review their staff strength vis-a-vis. They have to do. What is that we have in our hand to control that the executive are doing this particular activity or not? That means reviewing the cadre strength, whether they are doing it or not. What is that weapon we have? I'll let you know. So the redundancies have to be identified by they themselves can benefit. You know, it is not that we get benefit. Finance has to know. It is the executive will get benefit because at the time of requirement they get money in the vacancy bank by doing so. So they it will be helpful for them. Then you will have. That the revenue expense index, that is the earnings average receipt for passengers, as it is average receipt for TKM, that is goods side, it is increasing. But now during the pandemic, figures I didn't take, but definitely the average receipt for TKM will be slightly lesser. Though we didn't lose much on goods front, so 162 index it may go down, and the NTKM that is average receipt for the NTKM it will be almost at the same level during the pandemic area also and period also. When this is the situation of revenue, then going to the input cost. That means for taking our goods and passengers, how much, what are the items, important items? I listed only few important items and they are increasing trend only. So when there is increasing trend, then when our revenue index is dropping and when our input cost is increasing, it is necessary for us to control our staff cost. Then this also will indicate you, see, I was telling, because of the outsourcing or because of the technological innovations, whatever we are putting in, there should be vast reduction in the railway employment, but it is not so. The figures are not telling that it is not happening. It is not happening. See here, say 16 lakhs or 17 lakhs, you can say. So in 2010-11, they have become 13 lakhs, and 2018-19, they are 12 lakhs. So in the span of around 20 years, only 4 lakhs only we could reduce the staff strength. Despite so many advancements in the technology we made, but the staff strength reduction is less. Whereas we are not adding anything to our RKMs, group kilometers, or we are not adding assets to a larger extent where manpower is required. But the number of staff strength is not commensurate with the improvements whatever we are bringing in. And coming to the expenditure side, you see, in 1991, it is expenditure per annum, it is 5,116 crores of rupees, 51,766 rupees in 2010-11, and 2018-19, you can imagine 1,34,360 crores. That means one side the staff strength is not reducing at the expected level, and on the other side the expenditure is going exponentially. So the average wage per employee, if you take say it is 3 crores, now it is 109 average crores of rupees, average per employee. It is 1 lakh, it is coming, 1,09,000 crores it is coming. So this is how you will appreciate that there is a need to contain the staff cost. And one more important point is that in 2018, the ratio of staff cost in open line, excluding the pensionary element, I am not adding here pension element, to OWE, if you work out the percentage, excluding DRF and pension fund, the appropriation funds, they remove that, and it is coming to 59%. On individual zonal railways also, if you take, almost they will be similar. So around 59% of ordinary working expenses, that is sub-major head 1 to sub-major head 11, if they are to the extent of 59%, we can imagine that there is much to be done. That is, the effective utilization of the manpower, if it is done, then there is a possibility for reduction of the staff cost. So, having said that, now I will go into the actual subject matter, that is finance establishment related. Normally, what it does in finance establishment? Normally, whenever creation of additional posts are required, they come to finance concurrence. So that we will see. And the revenue posts, whenever the continuation of that particular activity, if we feel that it may be for a particular period, normally we give concurrence for a temporary revenue post. We will clearly mention that it is a temporary revenue post. In such case, so year to year, they require to come to finance, duly justifying the further extension of the post. So we will examine, and then we will be giving concurrence to the extension of the temporary revenue post. So that means the basic difference between a temporary revenue post and a revenue post is period, the tenure. Here, the temporary revenue post has a fixed tenure. Generally, we will be giving 1 year, from 1/4 to 31/3. Generally, we will be giving temporary revenue post from 1st April to 31st March. So, by January, they should come up with a proposal that whether they require this post or not. If they don't require, then they can surrender the post and the money value can go into the surplus bank. So, this is how, and one more important point is that in our cadre check statements for gestet and even scale check statements also, definitely we will have to see that the extension sanction extension to the temporary revenue post is coming or not. If it is not coming, then for provisional payment, GM or DRM has having powers for 3 months, and yes, that can be done. And then later on, n number of posts you are keeping, and the money whatever you are paying, you have to keep under objectionable items, and then under miscellaneous irregularity, and tell the executive that so and so many posts are kept under unsanctioned expenditure. Please obtain the sanction of competent authority so that the amount can be removed from the objectionable items. So this is how we have to do. It is important, this aspect need to be checked in establishment sections. They should flag how many posts are temporary revenue posts. We got a, let me tell you one experience, around 9 posts of gestet in civil engineering branch, they were given as temporary revenue post by Railway Board, because Railway Board sanction is required. We have been operating and Railway Board is giving, but at one particular point of time, no proposal has gone, but the posts are getting operated and the establishment section did post them in the objectionable items register. And finally, after 2 years or 3 years, when we woke up and saw, and then when proposal has gone to Railway Board, then we have got a very, we have to put our head in shame, because for 2 years, our missionary has failed to check that, yes, we have to keep in objectionable item and we have to write to executive. So that aspect was lost. So we have to keep that in mind. Then conversion of temporary post into permanent ones. You all aware that the conversion of temporary post into permanent one, it is a continuous process. Whenever 80% of posts you can convert, and whenever the need is felt that yes, the continuance is there, there is three-member committee, a secret committee will be there, and they will sit and they recommend, and then those posts, if you agree, that is finance concurrence, they will come, and then we agree, then automatically 80% of the posts they can come on permanent posts, so that the workload will come down in establishment section as well as in finance section. So this is how it will be done. And last one post under any particular cadre it is, then 80% of posts can be converted to permanent ones. So 80% more than 50%. That means that post also can be converted. And in under any cadre, all the temporary posts can be converted. So this is how it should be done. Then more important point is that now let us go to the second segment. What is the work of church for execution of the work? Number of posts are required, or a particular number of non-gestures are required. So man months will be provided, and expenditure will money also will be made available depending upon the where it direction and general charges. The establishment, when a project estimate is made, so there the details of the posts are also will be given, and then percentages as prescribed by Railway Board, how it will be done, with block or without block, different percentages in them, and the percentages also, the major department will have the highest percentage, and other departments, how much percentage they have to keep under the direction and general charges on the total money, how much percentage to be distributed in accounts, vigilance, or other electrical departments. So how it should be distributed, the percentage will be there accordingly. So this is finance expenditure they have to look into, and then accordingly percentages with that is direction and general charges, establishment, other than establishment. So the work charge post will be created for under establishment charges. So it should be within that. So whatever number of posts they are required, they should give number, grade, and what is the money value of that, and how many man months that it is required. So that is how. So this is about creation of work charge post. Suppose the work is over, what will happen? The estimate provision is over. You cannot increase the estimate provision. So once estimate provision is there, to that extent only you have to, or work is completed, to that extent only we will be giving a concurrence, and later on we cannot give concurrence. Then they have to give fresh justification on another estimate, and this post is required to be operated there, so therefore further extension may be given. So it's given in given such circumstances, yes, it can be agreed to. But majority of the time, wherever the pay commission chain recommendations are there, the executives will come to finance stating that no, the expenditure has gone up, so therefore we will be revising this. No, absolutely you cannot revise. Even on the revised estimate also, the percentage only will be fixed, and accordingly the post will be maintained. So then one more point is that the work charge post conversion of upcharge post into revenue post. It is a misnomer. Whenever it is a because based on the particular justification workload, we'll be agreeing for concurring the creation of upcharge post. Suppose on revenue side, the same work it has to be done on revenue side, and they need separate justification. They should give the separate justification and matching money value. Then only we'll be accepting for revenue. So even though they call it as a conversion of work charge post into revenue post, you should treat it as that it is a creation of revenue post only, because the work charge post definition, per se definition, is that worth of charge. When there is no worth of charge, no. When the same work has to be continued in open line, yes, you can continue. So that is how the creation of work charge post will be done. Similarly, this work charge post generally from 17 to 36 will be. Sometimes piecemeal also they may ask, executive may ask, but in finance we will be mostly giving only for entire 1 year. So 1 year provision, suppose some 10 estimates they have, they identified the provision under 10 estimates under direction and general charges. So those 10 estimates provision coming to 12 man months, then we will be giving for 12 man. So in the sanction memorandum also, they are required to give the works for which the concurrence was sought, and then in the sanction memorandum they have to attach the work code, name of the work, and the amount man months to be charged they have to give. Otherwise, because this sanction memorandum, one copy anyhow it will come to finance establishment, and one copy has to go to establishment section. So in establishment gesture section, they will have to, there is a cadre register is there, especially for gesture. Absolutely there is no problem, because you will be maintaining a cadre register, and there you will, on the top of that, the name of the, against the name of the officer, you will write it is a work charge post or temporary post. Available from so-and-so. So whenever his salary is passed, then you will be charging to those posts. But if you are not doing this on concurrent basis, that is month to month, if you are not doing, and if you forget to take out all the amount that you have booked to revenue and transfer to the works wherever the concurrence was given, so to those works, if you are not transferring, then that will again catch the eye of audit, because from revenue to work charges should go, but you are not sent. So therefore, the establishment sections especially, they should keep a watch, especially section officers, where after passing of the bill, wherever such posts are there, you have to see that a JV is prepared and sent to those works. That is most important. Then one more thing is, another important point, especially the 6 monthly review of loco pilots and guards. This will be done based on the last corresponding 6 months period. Suppose January to June you are taking. So January to June for this year, last year figures we will be taking. Based on that, the fortnightly hours, how many hours they have worked, average for hours we will be taking from CTRs, then divided by the statutory hours, say 104 hours, so divided, and then number of people, number of pilots or loco pilot, assistant loco pilots required, that number will come, and on that we will be adding certain percentages. So this is how it will be done. Similarly, guards, and especially for goods, this is the procedure. And for coaching side, if you have to go, there will be links. So all these links, they will give, traffic plan they will give, working timetable they will give, and then HOIR certification, especially for loco pilots and guards, HOIR certification for passengers zone. So passenger trains operation links and HOIR certification is most important. Then they have to certify that these are most economical links, and accordingly whatever number it was arrived, and on that again certain percentage of on leave reserve, train reserve, so like that we will be adding. It depends on railway to railway, and then we will be continuing that number of posts. So that most important point is that the number of posts that are to be created is existing posts how many, and number of posts, additional posts that are to be created, only those posts only will be created. Suppose there is a reduction, suppose now there is a reduction in workload, so naturally the number of loco pilots and guard posts will come down. So when they come down, automatically those posts will be removed. Suppose 100 posts have become 90 posts, so the 10 posts will be removed from the book of sanctions. Suppose they are increased, so we will be taking either decrease or increase, we will be taking the approval from the AGM, and then accordingly our BOS will be altered. Most important point here, which normally we'll be looking at, is that for creation of posts, there is no need for matching money value. And when you surrender, the money value will not go to surplus bank. Because when at the time of creation, we are not taking, that means the running review, that is the running post creation, will not have any link with the money value that is available in the surplus bank or vacancy bank. So whether money value is not there or not there, we will not utilize for creation. Similarly, it is not linked with the vacancy bank. Similarly, loco pilots and guards, if a reduction is there, that money value, as for revenue post, how the money value will be calculated and it will go into surplus bank, here it will not go. So for local, for running posts, no, there is no link with surplus bank or vacancy bank. So please remember that, and we will knowing about that. Then identification of pilot and handicapped stations. This is also is a part of finance establishment related work. So normally, all of us, we knew that running the allowance will be given to the drivers and, as an incentive, that is running staff, they will be getting that as an incentive. But if to protect their earnings not falling, there will be certain sections where even though they work, they cannot earn even 50 kilometers or 120 kilometers also. So those sections will be identified as a pilot section and handicapped section, which will not allow the pilots to earn the requisite kilometrage. So to put a loss, there is a minimum kilometrage it will be added, and then the kilometrage allowance will be paid. So what is the problem here? One side, when no staff are not there, they'll say, and another side, staff are there, but they are not gainfully employed. So in such case, normally railway board directives are there, that the review of pilot and handicapped sections has to be done on concurrent basis, and wherever traffic bottlenecks or impediments are there, wo sabhi nikalna padta. Generally, it will not happen. Or that means unnecessarily, that is without getting the work done, we are making payment, additional payment we are making. So that primary purpose, when a proposal for pilot and handicapped sections for further extension, if anything is required, we will be looking at that. Why those impediments were not taken off? Why we are still continuing? So this is the aspect which finance establishment normally we will see. Then at the end of normally as on 1/4, the personal branch will make out the certification of BOA. They prepare the book of sanctions and they ask for certification. Normally, how the certification will be done? When it is created, you knew you are having the sanction memorandum. And what about attrition or surrenders? But if, as I already told, for surrenders, they will not come to finance. The executive will take a review of the work and then they will surrender the post. So, when they surrender the post, the surrender memorandum will be issued by personal branch, and the P branch, whatever surrender memorandum issues, they are the creation memorandum and surrender memorandum of each of the branches, they will be coming to finance establishment also, apart from other sections. So, based on the strength of them, the BOS for each of the grade, it will be reduced or increased, and the, as on 1/4, what is the sanction strength, that will be given, and we will be certifying, that is, finance establishment will be certifying the BOS. And based on the BOS, suppose some reduction is there or some increase in the posts are there, then they will be pinpointed to various stations, and then the distribution of the posts will. So this is, and that distribution also should be, some total of the distribution should be as given in the BOS, no less, no extra. So this is stations, the pay bills when you receive, you will be maintaining. That is normally in finance establishment, it will not be done. And the bill passing sections, that is the establishment section, they will do this scale check. That is, what are the total number of posts that were given and what are the total number of posts that are being operated, whether excess operated. Suppose in one, if it is excess operated, immediately the establishment section, they have to write to the executive that excess is operated. But however, if a lower post is operated, excess posts are operated against higher posts, they will give suitable remark in the scale check and you may accept that. And another important point is that certification of vacancy bank and surplus bank. Now, what if this vacancy bank or surplus bank or pool of surplus posts in the divisions under DRM, whatever posts are there, so as on 1/4, how many posts that can be surrendered? So they can be flat, and without money value, the number of posts can be kept under the pool of surrender posts. So whenever the creation is required at the divisional level, so they can do that, and at that point of time, simultaneously, the money value will be taken, and for the surrender post and for the created post also, money value will be taken, and then the post will be created. But there are certain restrictions that will be taken. So this is at the divisional level, pool of surrenders. At railway level, we'll be having a vacancy bank or surplus bank, will be maintained by Deputy CPO, and the state, depending upon the statements received from the various P branch units, that is statement A and statement B, annexure A and annexure B will be there. So those posts, that is supernumerary posts and regular posts, how many posts are surrendered, how many posts are added, so that will come and it will be compiled at headquarters, and then the total money value will be arrived at every month. Every month it will be arrived at, and then that money value will be certified by accounts branch also, and with the signature of Deputy CAO and Deputy CPO, that statement will go to Railway Board. So there, the total money value will not go into headquarters. Suppose some division has surrendered the particular post, then 50% it will go to division pool, and 35% it will be in headquarters pool, and 15% it will go to Railway Board. So whenever a division could not create the post, if money value is not there, they can write to P branch, and they will identify from other departments and then give to for creation of the post if it is in MLP. Suppose Zonal Railway as a whole, if you are not able to, if a particular department or Zonal Railway as a whole, if it is not having money value sufficient to create the post, then we can ask the Railway Board with detailed reasons why we are seeking the money value to be given with the finance conference. A letter can go from General Manager to Railway Board. So they will see, they will utilize this Railway Board vacancy bank money value, and then they give it to Railways. So this is all about the vacancy bank and surplus bank. So this vacancy bank or surplus bank and creation of posts is linked. If money value is not there, so this is what I was making a mention in my first slide, that the executive has a role to play because it is in his own interest, in his department own interest, he has to identify the surpluses and surrender the post. Because when he surrenders the post, the post money value will be available in the surplus bank. So when further extra activity has come and you have to create the post, then in such case, the money value that is available in the surplus bank that can be utilized for creation of the revenue post in his department. So that will be the propelling force for the executive to identify the pockets of redundancies. Otherwise, they continue to not utilize, underutilize the manpower, and we continue to pay the salaries, but without effective work getting done. So, and one more important point, without reviewing and without reducing, and if any additional asset is coming up in that department, they go on asking for creation of posts. So when they go on asking for creation of posts, there should be matching money value in the surplus bank. So when, at least for that purpose, they go on, that is executive departments, they go on surrendering the posts. It is a concurrently they will be doing, any particular activity is coming down, they will identify and the post will be signed. But you may be getting a doubt, sir, when body is available, what should we do? When a body is available also, even then you can flag that particular post. How to flag that particular post? When identified as surplus, but body is available, then what to do? Then you create a super. Create a supernumerary post. So what is the advantage of that supernumerary post? It will be personal to the incumbent. So personal to the incumbent means suppose the person who is there, suppose he is retiring in 2025. So it will be operated for 3 years and later on it will be automatically surrendered. So, for your purpose, that means you have identified and that will be physical, technical surrender will be there immediately and physical surrender will be done after 3 years and then the post will go in. You will not make any recruitment, the branch will not make any recruitment and you will not make any payment. And the amount will be, the sanctions will be reduced to that extent. So this is how it will be done. So that is supernumerary. Where body is available. Where body is not available, absolutely no issue. Directly surrender memorandum it can be given. And then the money value, as per the prescribed percentages, it can go into the surplus. And as soon as that surrendered, and while certifying BOS, that amount will be reduced. The number of posts will get reduced. And whenever you are creating a post, those number of posts will get added to the BOS in the then, normally, of course, nowadays there is no extra work that is being done outside office hours. So, and everything it is computerized. So, therefore, on rhodium you are not giving, but only in case of pension revisions, sometimes there will be honorarium payment due to implementation of pay commission, successive pay commissions, and per case basis they will work out. Then, when rate is not available, for fixing the rate of how much you have to pay per case, per employee and per supervisor, how much you have to pay in P branch and in accounts branch. So the proposal will come and reasonableness will see and then will be compliance. And subject to availability of funds, the payment will be made. Then one thing is, whenever there will be traveling posts and straight away, even 31 days also, sometimes they will be asking for traveling allowance to be payable. But in such cases, strict review has to be done, and then wherever the travel is there, then the traveling allowance has to be given on a consolidated basis. So whenever that consolidated basis traveling allowance need to be given, then for fixation of that, the proposal will come and we will examine how much we can be given for 25 days or 20 days, how much can be given, and accordingly conference will be given and the payment will be done. And then one more important point is that in the hospitals, the most of the time there will be shortage of doctors, especially in the pandemic situation also, they require to take medical personnel, paramedical personnel. So whenever such things are there, for outsourcing, definitely we can agree. And for CMPs, how many number of posts that can be given for month of medical practice, how many doctors can be taken, that concurrence only will be given. And the rest of the thing, it will be taken over by the branch and the medical branch. Similarly, in case of colleges, there will be vacancies. Some people will be going on leave, and the subject cannot be taught by someone else. And then they have to engage part-time lecturers, and how much rate it will be given. Generally, we'll be giving where that college is attached to a particular university or a board. What is the percentage that is available in the respective university or board? Generally, for part-time lecturers, how much they will be giving? Similarly, same pay will be giving and give concurrence. And the proposal should come, so then only the payment can be arranged. Okay. So this is how. Similarly, visiting specialists in hospitals, there are a number of visiting specialists for each hospital. They have available as identified, and then we have to give concurrence. The only thing is to give concurrence, and then the specialist will be appointed. So these are the important matters that will require finance consultation. And if you go to SOP, there are very clear wherever finance concurrence is required, they have given, and accordingly the proposals will come and we have to examine them. Normally, what is the basis on which we can give? Suppose 10 posts are required or 100 posts are required. What is that? How can we give? So there are certain yardsticks or norms for creation of posts. They are given. Each of the department, they have got their directorial committee they will be appointing, and then they will fix the yardsticks. Normally these yardsticks, some years together, the same pattern, same yardstick will be there. Revision will not be there. So they will be static. Even though the technology improvements are there, they will not change, because the Railway Board has given this is the norm or this is the yardstick. So based on that, they will present the proposal. What we have to see is we have to keep the entire thing, entire the proposal in its entirety we have to see. Why I am telling is, I will tell one case study. Say for example, track machines organization is there. We received a proposal that the two shifts people we have already given. What they are telling is, we have got certain parameters for each of the machine, it has to work. So there is no block that is being given by operating department. So therefore, we want to do night shift also. So as per the yardstick and as per the norm, they have sent. But what we require to see is it that require, what is that? Suppose even in night time also, suppose the trains are running in full, then what will happen? It is a moot point that we have to discuss. If you simply agree, then it is unproductive. That means you will be recruiting the people, but you cannot get the job done. That, the proposal itself is contradictory, because already posts are there. Already even vacant posts are there. Men are there. and you are not able to give the employment. On the other hand, you want one more shift and then give the create post. How ridiculous it is. Not only that, we have seen that when we have gone, that is for each of the machine, yardstick will be there. So that yardstick, we have to apply. So for each of the posts, how many posts are required to be created? When, one railway has sent a proposal, but to our surprise, when we looked at the RSP, they are not the machines have not been received. Machines have not been received, but they sent the proposal for creation. Not only that, very important point is that a finance proposal, especially establishment proposal, how it should be seen, it cannot be defined. It cannot be defined. We have to see ourselves, we have to think, and then from each of the angle, can you imagine that without the receipt of the machine, they are asking for a creation of posts? Yes, they may be having a point. They may be telling that no. The recruitment will take a long time. That is a different issue. But how can you ensure that the machine is coming and then they are, by the time they get recruited, the machine will be there? So we have to keep all these things in view, and then we have to keep. Not only that, one more case study I'll tell you. For additional quantity or increased quantity, they will be asked. But they never go in for existing missionary, existing staff. They never do. Suppose a yardstick has been downwardly reviewed. Suppose a few activities have been increased, either on SNT side or on analytical side or on local side. They come for additional quantity, they come for with the revised yardsticks given by the report. But as a finance officer, we have to see for the all existing assets also, we have to apply the same formula. If we apply the same formula holistically, then there may not be requirement for creation of posts. So this is, you have to be very, very careful about these yardsticks and posts. And many times, there will not be any yardstick for some phases of work. In such cases also, you did not return the proposal. You examine the proposal. Is it the proposal, is it okay within the parameters given, manpower they said, and the money value they took, and everything, if it is okay, you give, and that will form a norm. Locally, that can also be done. Okay. Then, when the yardsticks are so, they are not changeable over the period, because once the yardstick is given, we have to live with that. Even though you ask the executive, no, you require so many only, why you are asking so many? They will not give them. So therefore, now we are shifting that to benchmarking, especially in the wake of right sizing, we are going in for benchmarking. What is this benchmarking? It is a simple tool, Excel tool. What are the on-roll strength, how much it is available, what is the, there are certain activities that were identified. Suppose less than 80 locos, how many people they should be. More than 80 locos, how many people they should be. Like this they have given. So that will be the benchmark. Suppose the railway board will take for entire Indian Railway, for each of the locations. I am giving an example only. So for each of the local shed, and they will plot a diagram, map. So they will say, so in a particular local shed, there will be low manpower, and in a particular local shed, high manpower, and in a particular local shed, there will be average. So IRBM is the average of this, IRBM, IR benchmark, benchmark. And lowest is 1 and highest is 1. So from IR average, always whenever any locomotion is on IR average, then they should bring it to IRBM, still lower level. So this is how the requirement should be checked. Simply whenever any new locomotion comes, they go for, they send proposal for creation of say 200 posts or 300 posts for the new locomotion alone. So being in finance, because the finance establishment core activity is that one, being in finance, so take benchmarking. Ask them to send the benchmarking of all the locomotions that are available, say diesel locomotion or electric locomotion. So take that. Then you will arrive at some locomotions, they may be having more than IR average benchmark. Then the railroad letter says that you should bring down to the IR average. So what is the difference? So to that extent, they can transfer the post with body or without body. They can post also, they can transfer. And that is how the number of posts that they ask for 200, they may finally come down to 10 posts or 90 posts. This is how, that is why I said, these are the few case studies which I wanted to discuss, because these will give an idea how to look at a finance establishment proposal. A particular way only we have to see, no, that is not, that cannot be preserved. Even in our code book also, under finance chapter, it was never preserved how to do, but some essential checklists, etc., they may be there. What are the requirements that are to be enclosed to a particular proposal? That only will be there. But it will not, how to check a proposal is your ingenuity that we have to keep. So, now let us go into the creation of posts. This, because this is going to be added to our fixed cost, so we have to be very, very careful. Already I told, these are the things that simplification of procedure, elimination of work, rearrangement of work, and rationalization. These are the things that essentially they should speak of. And it is not only incremental, the additional increase or decrease, no. For entire units, how many posts are required, and existing posts, how many sanctions are. So, minus it. Only the remaining posts only. Whenever you give the remaining posts or whenever you are giving concurrence, you apply the percentages, interest rate percentages, distribution of posts will be there. So those percentages anyhow, sometimes they will ask only in lower. No. Whatever percentages are prescribed in the restructuring, so those percentages here. And accordingly, money value they are. Please keep that also. So, finance establishment generally, two level concurrence will be there, the divisional level or unit level, and then what's level also. But now, for DRM was given certain powers to create the post, then he can create subject to money value, that is subject to the conditions that are attached. New assets, operating and maintenance, or new assets, safety aspect on 1:1 basis. Yes, it can be done. There is no need to send to that. Okay. Then, the main hurdle for revenue posts, as I was discussing, it is the money value that is matching. Some one post you require, suppose 1 lakh it is required, so 1 lakh money you have to show in the surplus. Then only the post can be created. Then, DRM, yes, as already I told you, maintenance and operation of new assets can be created on 1:1 basis, that means simultaneously one post. Whatever center post is there, that post can be divided, and then one more post can be created after achieving the target of 1% of the surrenders from the pool of surrender posts. Now, what is this pool of surrender posts? Is at the beginning of the year, the posts that are not required or need not be filled, they will put in the pool of surrender. What is the advantage of this? There will be no recruitment request, requisition will be sent to RRBs, RRRs. So that way you will be keeping, and whenever you are requiring for maintenance and operation of new assets, you can take the post then on 1:1 basis. This is how. So man post, so whatever post you can do, then a register will be maintained just like vacancy bank in your purpose. Similar way, it will be done because the branch and the post offices will be done. Then, other than safety also, for existing assets can be created only at the GM level, not at the divisional level. So this you have to keep it in mind. Then, for new assets, for maintenance and safety point of view, that can be done at the unit. Then, what is new asset? Asset created by construction or your position, acquired by open land organization, including rolling stock, whatever. That is what so, percentage distribution already I gave. And if the division is not having money value on 1:1 basis, then they can send the proposal to headquarters and GM sanction. And running category, as I already told, is based on 6 monthly review, and it is not linked to the matching money salary from the vacancy bank. And the most important point is that the mean pay plus DA, that is the money value. So, but this mean pay plus DA has been recently revised. Cell 1 to cell 10. How much minimum and cell 10? What is the pay? So that mean pay plus DA, current DA, that will be taken as the money value of that particular. So because of this, certain posts that were surrendered earlier also to be reviewed, and that surplus bank money value has come down. So we have to ask the B branch to review, because it is downward review. So we have to ensure that that work is done. Otherwise, the money value will be there and they go on for the post. So that normally, one department surrender money value that is available in the bank, that can be with the approval of general manager, that can be used by other department also. But generally, because if that is done, only that department will not continue to surrender, and other department will continue to create the post. So normally, it will not be done. But the rule says that yes, GM can appropriate the money value in the surplus bank from one department to another department. And in case of money value is not there, we can write to Railway Board also. Okay. But one important point is that if any surrender of post taking place due to work study or post identified by Railway Board, suppose 10,000 posts are surplus, so you cannot. So those posts, they cannot be entered to surplus bank. Then the revenue post, guested, Railway Board is held first, and non-guested, general manager and DRM. So this is as per the SOP, you can do that. And vacancy or surplus bank, I have already told that 50% to divisional vacancy bank, 35% to for surplus bank, and 15% to Railway Board vacancy bank. And posterior report shall not be used for creation. This already I told. So from with the approval of general manager, it can be taken by other departments. Finance certifies the availability before putting up to general manager. Finance B-branch sends the proposal, and then that also we will be verifying matching money value, and then we will be noting down in our surplus bank file, and then the proposal will go to GM, and GM will send it. Then at the end of the month, when they send the proposal, how much balance that is available, we will verify with these statements. So this, already told, cell 1 and pay cell 10 only, plus DA that should be taken, and downward revision, yes, it was done. And temporary revenue post, as I told, 142 to 313. And sanction, it can be done by PHOD or CHOD, DRM or CW. Because already money value was given, and only currency is to be extended. And as I already told, the extension should be watched by establishment section. And 80% of those can be converted to permanent ones. And this also can be done by conversion, can be done by PHOD, CHOD, DRM and CWP. Mm-hmm. Pinpoint, that means you have given some 100 posts. And 100 posts not at one place, but different stations it has to be distributed. So that will be done with the approval of HOD, CHOD, DRM and CWM or JHE for Group D and R. So this is there available in the SOP and finance concurrence is required. Then permanent transfer of posts more than 1 year, it requires approval by PHOD, CHOD or DRM, CWM or JHE for Group D or R. So more than 1 year. Okay. Then supernumerary posts, as I already told, if you have to surrender the post immediately, but there is a body, then in that case it will be flat by creating the supernumerary post. Then that shadow post will be removed as and when that incumbent vacates, either gets promotion or resign, then in that case automatically the post will be removed. So this is how it will be done. Then especially the running category of LP, there is normally the different percentage, the procedure is one and the same, but percentages of extra percentages, they may vary from railway to railway, but the running category review will be done once in 6 months. That is 6 monthly review, April to September, October to March. And April to September should be completed by March, and October to March should be completed by September. So this is how it will be done. Accordingly, based on the review, it will be put up to general manager whether increase or post are there or decrease is there, and the AGM will sanction. And if it is decreased, BYS will be decreased, and if it is increased, this will be taken place, and the indent can be sent to RRB for recruitment. So this is how it will be done. Generally, because there is a time lag, we are not, now it is only from divisions, directly it is going to AGM without routing to PFA. And some other railway, there will be a different process. But the thing is, the 6 monthly review, it is to be done for arriving at the ALP, LP, GOTS and LIs, local inspectors. And it is not linked with the money value. That's all. If you knew this much, it is enough. So, for the goods trains, as I was making mention, previous 6 months, fortnight hours, how many are there? Last 6 months, we take, average it, and fortnightly, how much it is coming? And that will be divided by 104, and then number of posts. That number of posts will be base requirement. We call them as base requirement. Then, for that, different percent of LR, traffic fluctuation, relevance in lieu of time loss, etc., it will be added, and then on that the trainee reserve will be added. So this is how the requirement of proof for goods trains will be arrived. Then similarly for coaching trains also, there will be, as I said, links, passenger links will be there. HOR certification will see, working timetable will see to check the timings. And then save statement anyhow they will give. Then the basic requirement will be arrived based on the links, and for that LR and TR will be there, and this will be arrived. But as I was making mention, please remember that the percentages may vary from railway to railway. Okay. Now we should remember that there will be no ALP will be given to motor cars, and ALP number of ALPs are not considered for arriving at the local inspector. Because for local inspector, there is for every 50 shunters, one local inspector can be given, like that it is there. And that will be, at that point of time, ALP will not be considered. Then guard post also, almost the same as ALP or ALP will be given, only percentage will change. That's all. LR percentage is 32, and the allowance in lieu of time loss, etc., will not be there here. This is also purely depending upon the local railway to railway differences that we have to keep in mind. Then Goose tanks, it will be again average number of hours, fortnightly hours, average hours, and then divided by 104, how many number will come. But here also, the LR, DR, traffic fluctuation, LSLU will be added, and then number of dot posts will be added. So shunters, depending upon the activity, it will be done, and based on justification, you will be examining. And local inspector, one local inspector for 25 LPs. So ALP will not be taken here, and LR will be added in case of LP poaching only, not goods. Okay. Then one LI for every 50 shunters will be. So this is as per the yardstick, that is yardstick or JPO. Each railway will be having accordingly will be given. So the pilot and handicap sessions already I told. So we have to ensure that is there any reduction. But from my experience, there is increase in the number of sections, but not decrease. So we have to ensure. We have to intimate the executive that why there is increase and why you are not removing the identifying the handicapped and pilot section is to remove the handicapped and pilot sections. Not for continuance, okay, continuance, but you have to remove, but in addition, you are adding them. So that is not correct. So that we have to keep it in mind. So then creation or work charge imposed. That is already I told that it is based on the worth of charge. Especially for gestured post, there is the yardstick and the outlay. Here, outlay means the amount that is made available for a project. Yardstick is for this much yard, for this much outlay. Yardstick is how many posts that can be created. So this is how it will be done. So justification and it will be done for 1 year provision will ensure, and then it will be from 17 to 36. Whenever extension is there, we have to ask for, we will be asking for estimate provision as well as continuity certificate and the availability of funds. These are the three things we will be asking for work charge. What are they? For creation of post, estimate provision and availability of funds. And for creation of post, sorry, for extension of post, we will be asking for continuous operation of posts. If there are only 1 month it is created, then we will be asking why it is required. So this is how it will be done. Then proposal shall be routed normally. It will be prepared because it is a work charge post. It will be prepared by executive department, but routed through by P branch. Revenue post, it will be done by P branch and coming directly to finance. So this is how it will be done. Okay. And approval will be given by PHOD and concurrence will be given by PFA. Then sanction memorandum will be issued by PCPO because he is the bill drawing officer. So bill drawing officer will require the number of posts and each post to which estimate it is required to be charged. Then only the establishment section will be in a position to book the expenditure. So this is how it will be done. Then sanction posts, JAG, up to above JAG, well above, and up to JAG, GM or lower. This is how it will be done. But I am not going into the yardsticks for the gestured staff now, because for each of the department and organization, how many posts that can be created based on the outlay and the yardstick that is available every year it gives. If it is not giving, last year yardstick you can apply, and then can three concurrence can be given as per that yardstick. And similarly, case of gestured, how many posts, for how many posts in SAG, how many posts you can operate in HAG, all these things it will be given. And I will not go into that. So every detail it is given, each department, how it should be worked out, and certain concessions you have to give. Suppose the RVNL is doing, then entire yardstick will be not taken. Or RVNL work you are taking up and doing, then proportionately you have to take. So these things in finance section you have to examine, then only the posts can be given. How many posts that senior scale to junior scale, how many percentage, how much ratio it has to be applied, everything is there. Similarly, weighted average, especially in case of stores, you have to give weighted average. Suppose the stores are being procured by, suppose machine is being procured by Kaufman, then to that extent you have to remove from out here, and then for the remaining only you have to take for creation of this course. So this is how it should be done. So I'll not take much of your time for checklist, because this is only, as I was making a mention, it is only the essential thing that is required to be accompanied with a proposal. But the most important point is how to check a particular proposal. It is mostly based on our experience. So here, yes, I'll stop, and if now let us have the interactive session. I request the participants to ask questions, or any if you want to share your experience, you can share your experience. Please do so.
Hello. बोलिए तो हाँ, क्या 271 उसका फोटो खींचा हुआ क्या आपके पास है क्या? अच्छा बोलिए 271 082 72 372, आपके पास भाउचर है ना?
Participants, now I am available for taking up your
Yeah, unmuted sir. Participants are unmuted.
Sir, good morning. Good afternoon, sir. Sir, somebody is medically decategorized.
Yeah.
Then they are given the supernumerary post.
Excellent.
So is this that is the only way to treat the medical decategorized, or this is one of the options in supernumerary post? It is not clear, sir. In our division, the practice is they keep the supernumerary post alive. But here you said, once we have to surrender, we keep it for 1 year. The body part is not the physical person. The physical person has to be there. That is the word you use, body. So for 3 years, after 3 years, that has to be surrendered, isn't it, sir?
Yes, yes.
But I have heard that it is not the case. So I just want to know where we are lagging and who's right.
Actually, the supernumerary post concept, whenever surrenders are taking place, where body is available. So that is one case. Because the, say, work study reports or railway board will pressurize us that you please surrender so many posts. In such cases, we have to accept, because the work study report says that you don't require so many posts and you have to surrender. So the PHOD will take a call and then surrender the post. But suppose suppose some bodies are available, then in that case, how to give to railway board that compliance report? So how can we give compliance report without surrendering? Only we can post, I surrendered, and no, I am not going to surrender body post. No, it cannot be done. So that is why the body post also surrendered. Technically, we will say surrender. So it will be taken off from the save statement, sanctions, and then later on you will be having this supernumerary post, because there is a body, say for 2 years or 3 years or for 6 months, whatever it may be, till as long as that the person is available, you have to keep. Suppose he gets a promotion, then automatically that flagged post will be, that supernumerary post will be. So this is how the procedure has to be followed, and especially in our establishment sections, wherever this supernumerary post is created, you have to keep that an eye on the supernumerary post. That is one. Second, there is the personal branch also, they cannot keep requisition on the RRB because it has been removed from the sanctions that we are restricting. Third one. Second case is that, as you said, medical decategorization or invalidation that takes place. So in such cases, we cannot ask him to do the same job, and you have to keep somewhere else. So some other work you have to do. So a supernumerary post will be created. So that means no assigned job will be there, and whatever he could do, that what you can get done, and then that supernumerary post will be nullified when he takes voluntary retirement, then you can remove that. So that is third case where the supernumerary post will be created is that normally these post persons, out of turn promotions they will be giving, the railway board will give an order that so-and-so is from head clerk to chief clerk, he has been promoted for doing so-and-so. So in such cases also, this supernumerary post will be created, the difference between the revenue two revenue posts that will be given from matching money value, and that supernumerary post it will be wiped off when the sports person gets his regular promotion. So this because of this you can ensure that the regular incumbents whoever are there, they are not deprived of that promotion. See, these are the things which normally will be taken as far as supernumerary posts are
concerned. Thank you so much,
sir.
Well explained. Thank you.
Sir, what gap analysis are in medical department?
Matching surrender?
Gap analysis.
Time analysis. Job analysis.
Gap. GAP, sir.
Job analysis.
Job analysis. Okay. Normally, of course, our accounts also will involve in the job analysis, especially when the HOIR, as per the HOIR rules, because of TVUs increasing, freight vehicle units increasing, and a particular classification of HOIR from, say, essentially intermittent to extensive. If you have to change that, generally the executive will take a call and then ask for reclassifying a particular station or a particular gate to be classification needed to be changed. Suppose essentially intermittent is 12 hours and exclusive it is fortnightly will be taking. So in such cases the job analysis for 3 days or so will be taking, and how many train vehicle units are going, and how much less percentage is how much idle time is there, and how much active time is there. So this is how we will be analyzing, and then the report will be submitted both from our executive side and from our account side, and based on that, the HOIR classification of the station or the gate. That will be changed. So that means you knew that there is a change in the HOIR, and then thereby you may be incurring more expenditure or you may be incurring less expenditure. But as per HOIR rules, if we are getting more work done, taking from our employee, we should be more. So accordingly.
Please explain, sir, HOIR.
Our self-employment regulation. Normally, this is just like our finance conference, our accounts people will do the HOIR certification, that is infringement of rules of employment should not be there because we are the largest employer in the government sector. So we should not infringe any laws. So that infringement is not there. That will be certified by branch. That means suppose 10 hours rule is there. So 10 hours a person has to work. So within that 10 hours work is done or not, and that will be ensured by P branch when executive sends the proposal to us. So unless that HOIR, that is hours of employment regulation, that certification is there from our P branch, we will not check those running review links because any violation tomorrow we will be dragged to court. So that is why we always ensure wherever HOIR certification from P branch, how in our tenders we will be participating, how in our finance conference we will be giving our finance proposals. Similarly, for P branch items, there is a creation of posts wherever it is required, HOIR certification is required, that will be obtained by P branch and given to us. So, infringement of rules, HYR rules, that is hours of employment, sir. Suppose 12 hours I have to get the work done. So 12 hours I will be getting the work done. For extra work, whatever I get, I have to pay OT. So this will be decided based on the HYR regulations.
And is this for the running staff or operations staff? Or
running operations staff also. Not only running, no? So it is for say a commercial clerk or goods clerk or the booking clerk. So we are in that is a station master. Wherever this HOI certification. Yeah.
Is there any standard timing for HOIR or just
Yes. Depending upon the time, that is the classification of the roster. Is it essentially intermittent roster, or is it exclusive roster, or continuous roster? So for continuous roster, say 104 hours is required for 9. So 104 hours, anything it is done more than that, you will be getting overtime payment. So that overtime payment also, they will say, is it standard hours, and these are the actual worked hours, and out of that, whatever stand hours are there, remove, and then for extra hours, whatever it is that, as at the rate prescribed by Railway Board, we will be certifying that overtime, especially this is done in establishment section. That is why overtime allowance is a controllable. Similarly, travelling allowance is a controllable.
I have one question to ask, sir. Sir, is the work charge post out of the permanent, created out of the permanent post, sir?
No. I would like to say, in this particular case, normally revenue post is justified as per based on the continuous nature of work. That means the work will be continued for a while. With a view, the proposal itself says that it is a revenue post creation. Whenever they say that it is a revenue post creation, they are sure that they have to give matching money value from surplus bank. So these are two things that indicate that it is a revenue post. They want to go for a revenue post, and they want to offer matching money value, whatever cost of the post that is required from the cell 1 to sell, in the cell 1, what is the value, and cell 10 how much, and DA percentage how much, and that is the cost of the post they will arrive at, and this much money value, it is available in the surplus bank, they will tell. So accordingly, the post creation, for that post creation, they will come to us. But as far as work charge post is concerned, so they will say that a post is to be created based on the direction and general charges. Say for example, in our accounts department, I have to create a work charge post of say section officer, so senior section officer. So there is a provision, a particular estimate, and for so many months, say 12 months, I said not less than 12 months, so 12 months provision is available, and the work report of that particular work is so and so. So it is available in the estimate, and so they will certify all those things, and the estimate provision they will certify, and funds availability for this year, for the year that is from 1-7, funds are available from the big book they will show, or from the law book they will show, or from your LSWP they will show. Then accordingly, after certification only, they will be sending the proposal, and then you will be giving concurrence for the work charge post. Now, the moot point is, you are telling that a revenue post, can it be treated as a work charge post? Absolutely no, because for work charge post, separate justification is there. For a work charge post, separate justification is there. So, a person who is there in the revenue post, he can be transferred to a work charge post. So when, say, I am in revenue post, suppose I have been transferred to a work charge post, then my pay and allowances for that particular month, they will be charged to the work, but not to the revenue. maybe up to last month I was under revenue, but because I have been transferred to a work charging post, then you will be in your cadre register, you will be marking the Amala Prasad work charging post, and validity is up to so and so period and chargeable to so many works, that will be there. So accordingly my salary you will be put to the work charging post.
It may vary also, no sir. Yeah, it increase. It may increase also, is it, sir?
Increase means?
The salary, the remuneration.
There is absolutely no point. No problem. What I want to say here, work charging post, it is only man must, that is most important. Suppose the salary may increase, that you need not bother because you will be taking you, because as long as I am operating a particular post within the man months, suppose 12 man months or 18 man months, that is given. Suppose within 18 man months, suppose my pay and allowances may increase, maybe due to pay commission. Many times in our FE section, we face this particular problem. Whenever pay commission comes, they go on asking more and more money to be given. No, absolutely not required. Even you need not ask them to reduce the post subs. What you have to do is, it can be explained that extra, that excess, that can be explained because in the appropriation accounts you can explain that it is due to pay commission, saving pay commission. That is how it should be done. So the main focus as far as work charge post is concerned, we have to keep that man months portion, not more than or not less than. So more than we should not use. That is most important.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much.
Yeah. Any other?
Sir, checking point of creation of post, sir. Creation of post, sir. Kya check karte hain financial news?
Kaun sa post? Revenue post ya work charge post?
Work charge post.
Work charge post ka to creation ke bare mein, as I said, ये डिटेल एस्टिमेट में आपको होना चाहिए कि डिटेल डायरेक्शन एंड जनरल चार्जेस में वो पोस्ट का नाम है क्या, कितना मैन मंथ है, वो देखना पड़ेगा. एंड फॉर वर्क चार्ज पोस्ट, इवन फॉर क्रिएशन पहले तो डायरेक्शन एंड जनरल चार्जेस में एस्टिमेट में उसका पदनाम को लिखना है, रहना है और कितना मैन मंथ है वो होना चाहिए. एंड इट इज वन मोर इम्पोर्टेंट पॉइंट इज दैट इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी दैट इन वन एस्टिमेट ओनली ऑल द 12 मंथ्स शुड बी अवेलेबल. सपोज 10 एस्टिमेट्स आल्सो यू कैन एग्री मेकिंग इट 12 मंथ्स. इफ दे आर मेकिंग इट 12 मंथ्स देन यू कैन एग्री, एब्सोल्युटली नो प्रॉब्लम. बट फॉर एक्सटेंशन ऑफ पोस्ट व्हाट यू रिक्वायर इज अगेन ऑन अवेलेबिलिटी सर्टिफिकेट इज रिक्वायर्ड एंड एस्टिमेट प्रोविजन वेदर इट इज देयर और नॉट दैट इज आल्सो रिक्वायर्ड. इन एडिशन टू दैट you will be requiring continuous operation certificate. इससे पहले साल में वो तो ऑपरेट हुआ, अभी ये साल में भी ऑपरेशन के लिए जरूरत है. वैसा एक सर्टिफिकेट लेना है एग्जीक्यूटिव से, देन यू सी दैट द प्रोग्रेस ऑफ द वर्क एंड इफ इट इज गोइंग टू बी देयर देन यू कैन एग्री फॉर एक्सटेंशन ऑफ पोस्ट. एंड क्रिएशन, या क्रिएशन ऑल्सो इज for say 1 year, if they ask if that is there, even for 1 year, up to 1 year, it is going to be there, then you can agree. It is not necessary that only one estimate or one post. Suppose empty number of posts are there, if you come to this.
Sir, work charge post.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, work charge post or revenue post mein kya antar hai, sir?
Work charge post mein work ko aap salary jo bhi suppose 10 वर्क चार्ज, 10 सेक्शन ऑफिसर का पोस्ट समझिएगा, 10 सेक्शन ऑफिसर का पोस्ट वर्क चार्ज पोस्ट क्रिएट करें तो वो एस्टिमेट, जो एस्टिमेट से हमें क्रिएट किया, वो एस्टिमेट्स को आपका एस्टैब्लिशमेंट सेक्शन में ये पास करने, बिल पास करने के टाइम पे आप ट्रांसफर करना है. वो रेवेन्यू में नहीं रहेगा, रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंडिचर में, ऑर्डनरी रेवेन्यू एक्सपेंडिचर में नहीं आएगा. अगर गलती से आप करें तो भी मार्च अकाउंट्स में आप जेवी डाल के वो वर्क्स को आप ट्रांसफर करना है, दैट इज वर्क चार्जिंग पोस्ट. एंड दैट वर्क चार्जिंग पोस्ट विल बी अवेलेबल ओनली फॉर दैट charge post, then you sanction ke baad agar dusra sanction mila to rahega, nahi to nahi rahega. But whereas for revenue post, that is a permanent post. Whether I am there or not there in the post, that post will remain. And until executive takes a call, and काम तो खत्म हो चुका है, नहीं तो हमारा accounts का yardstick आ गया, तो yardstick के हिसाब से हमें calculate किए तो 10 post surrender करना, so 10 post surrender किए, तो वो चला जाएगा. And where it will go, that money value, that will money value will go to surplus bank. But in work charge post, nothing. The post, as long as you operate, it will be there. If it is not there, gone.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
During restructuring,
yes,
I surrendered some post.
Yeah.
That same can be created again.
No. Yes, as you said rightly.
It happens, sir.
Yeah, surrender post, they cannot qualify for posting into their surplus bank. If you do that, that self-financing of restructuring orders, it is difficult.
Yeah.
On behalf of Sitara, we thank Sri Damodar Prasad sir for his brilliant explanation of various aspects of finance establishment, and we thank all the participants who have attended today's lecture. Tomorrow, the topic is latest developments in freight traffic, and the speaker is Sri P.D. Christopher, Deputy Chief Operations Manager, South Central Railway, Secunderabad. User login time is 11 hours and the session will start at 11:30 hours. Thank you one and all. Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Recording stopped.